Now, let us commence with the academic procession. Please rise as we welcome the distinguished members of our faculty, administration, and honored guests. Leading the procession is our college marshal, followed by our candidates for graduation, accompanied by their parents or spouses. The candidates for graduation with their parents and spouses.
We'll be right back.
Now let's also welcome the administrative heads, faculty, and administrative staff of Aurora State College of Technology. Our key college officials, academic deans, our key college officials, our college president, Dr. Renato G. Reyes, together with our vice presidents of the college, Vice President for Academic Affairs, Dr. Maluz F. Kabatan, and the ASCOT Board of Trustees, good morning. Please take your seats. Before we proceed further, we invite everyone to participate in the Baccalaureate Mass, a moment of reflection and gratitude as we seek blessings for our graduates. Thank you.
check some.
Again, good morning, everyone. As one community of Christ, let us celebrate the Holy Mass together with our presider, Reverend Father John Anthony Los Banez. Please stand and let us sing the entrance song.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We are thankful for this Eucharist celebration today, as we will be witnessing our final march after 2, 4, or 5 years of wholesome learning experiences in our alma mater, the Aurora State College of Technology. Our theme for celebration is Expanding Horizons, Celebrating Inclusive Resilience and Innovative Graduates. As we chase to expand our horizons, today's reading reminds us of the different trials such as rejection, humiliation, dissonance, and alike along our way. But remaining strong in our faith to God will serve us, our greatest weapon, to be part of an inclusive, resilience, and innovative community servants and advocates. The challenge is, when we succeed in expanding our horizon, do we take time or do we give ourselves time to go back, to reflect and recollect and recognize the Word of God in our lives? Let us reflect.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
For the wicked attempts, deeds, and mindset that we nurture in our hearts because of greediness, selfishness, and pride, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For being stubborn, rude, and insensitive to the needs and concerns of others, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
For the times that we prepare to cheat, disguise, and lie just to be favored, recognized, and praised, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in this season give your church the grace to imitate devotedly from your bonds of sins, we have committed our weaknesses through the Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah.
I hear the whisperings of many. Terror on every side. Denounce. Let us denounce him. All those who were my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped. Then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him. But the Lord is with me, like a mighty champion. My persecutors will stumble. They will not triumph. In their failure, they will be put to utter shame, to lasting, unforgettable confusion. O Lord of hosts, you who test the just, who prove mind and heart, let me witness the vengeance you take on them, for to you I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
In my distress, I call upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
I love you, O Lord, my strength. O Lord, my rock, my fortress, my deliverer.
In my distress, I call upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
My God, my rock of refuge, my shield, my horn of salvation, my stronghold, praise be the Lord, I exclaim, and I am safe from my enemies.
In my distress, I call upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
The breakers of death surge around. The destroying floods overwhelmed me. The cords of the nether world enmeshed me. The snares of death overlook me.
In my distress, I call upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and cried out to my God. For his temple, he heard my voice, and my cry to him reached his ears.
In my distress, I call upon the Lord, and he heard my voice. Please stand to honor the Holy Gospel.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Jews picked up the rocks to stone Jesus, and Jesus answered them, I have shown you many good works from my Father, for which all of these are you trying to stone me? And the Jews answered him, We are not stoning you for a good work, but for being blaspheming. You, a man, are making yourself God. And Jesus answered them, It is not written in your law, I said, you are gods. If it calls them God, to whom the word of God came, and the scripture cannot be set aside, can you say that one whom the Father has consecrated and sent into the world blasphemies because I said, I am the Son of God. I do not perform my Father's works. Do not believe me, but I perform them even if you do not believe me. Believe the works so that you may realize and understand that the Father is in me and am I in the Father. Then they tried again to arrest him, but he escaped from their power. He went back across to the Jordan, to the place where John first baptized, and there he remained. And many came to him and said,
John performed no sign, but everything John said about this man was true, and many there began to believe in him. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Isang mapagpalang umaga sa inyong lahat.
Good morning po, Father.
Congratulations sa mga magtatapos ngayong araw na ito, no? Sa wakas, no? Natapos din, no? Pakibati ang inyong mga katabi ng isang congratulations. Of course, ang araw na ito ay pasasalamat sa biyaya ng Diyos na ating tinanggap, sa biyaya na kung saan hindi tayo karapat-dapat, pero ang Diyos ay patuloy na nagbibigay, nagbubuhos ng kanyang biyaya dahil sa kanyang umaapaw na pag-ibig at pagmamahal sa atin. Salamat dahil naranasan natin ang pag-ibig na ito, ang biyayang ito unang-una sa inyong mga magulang. Pangalawa, sa mga ating kaguruan dito sa Aurora State of Colleges, yung ASCOT, lalong-lalo na yung mga, para mga board of judges lang kayo, ano, yung mga sa unahan. Lalo na ang ating pinaka-active, no, and dynamic president, si Dr. Rene Reyes. Maraming salamat, Dr. Ren, sa iyong pagbibigay ng iyong sarili para dito sa Aurora, lalong-lalo na sa ASCOT. No? Palakpakan natin ang ating presidente. May tanong ako sa inyo. Naranasan niyo na ba na magbigay, mag-alay, at halos lahat na lang ibinigay mo na, sinuko mo na, minahal mo na siya ng sobra-sobra, pero di pa sapat, iniwan ka niya. Malamang naranasan nyo na. Yung lahat binigay mo, lahat pinagkaloob mo, lahat ng kahilingan niya, no? Pati ang sarili mo nakalimutan mo na para lang maging sapat ka para sa kanya. Pero sa biglang nagdaang panahon, na-realize niya, di ka pala sapat para sa kanya. Kung naranasan nyo yan, mas una itong naranasan ng ating Panginoon. At ito yung tema ng ating mga pagbasa sa araw na ito. Both from first reading in the book of the prophet Jeremiah and in our gospel from the gospel of St. John. In our first reading, no, naririnig natin yung panaghoy ni propeta Jeremiah. Sabi ni propeta Jeremiah, lahat ginawa ko na, lahat ibinigay ko, sumunod ako sa kalooban ng Diyos upang magpahayag ng mabuting balita. Ngunit anong ginawa ninyo? Hindi pa sapat ang ginawa ko. Ayaw niyo pang maniwala, pero manami na akong magandang ginawa. Pinadala ko dito ng Diyos upang ipakita ko sa inyo kung gaano katindi ang kagandahang loob ng Diyos. Pero anong ginawa ninyo? No? Naging matigas ang inyong mga ulo. To the point na gusto niyo akong patayin. Gusto ninyo akong habulin. Sapagkat ang mga salita ko ay katotohanan. At ang katotohanan ay ayaw ninyong pakinggan kasi taliwas sa uri ng buhay na isinasabuhay ninyo. Kaya nga yung panaghoy ni Propeta Jeremiah sa ating unang pagbasa ay isang panaghoy na kung saan tinatawag yung bawat isa sa atin ng isang panibagong uri ng buhay, yung transformation na hindi lamang sa ating kapaligiran, sa ating pisikal na kaanyuan, bagkus sa kailaliman, sa rurok ng ating kalooban. At ang pagbabagong ito ay hinahangad ni Propeta Jeremiah sa pamagitan ng pagbabagong anyo ng ating puso. At ito din ang sinabi ng ating Panginoon sa ating Ebanghelyo. Bakit maraming gustong pumatay kay Jesus sa araw na iyon? Kasi ang mga sinasabi ng ating Panginoon ay taliwas din sa uri ng buhay na isinasabuhay ng mga Hudyo, lalo na yung mga Pariseo at mga Eskriba. Masasabi natin na gusto siyang batuhin? Dahil sabi ng ating Panginoon, bakit gusto niyo akong batuhin? Marami na akong ginawang kababalaghan. Marami na akong himala. Nakita ninyo, nakakarinig yung mga bingi, nakakita ang mga bulag, nakakalakad ang mga pilay. No? Nakakapagpalayas ako ng mga masasamang espiritu. Nakita ninyo kung gaano ang tubig naging alak. At lahat ito, dahil ito sa kapangyarihan ng Ama na ipinagkaloob sa akin, sapagkat ang Ama at ako ay isa. Bakit ayaw niyo pang maniwala na ako isang tunay na sugo na anak ng Diyos? Ginawa ni Jesus lahat. Ayaw pa nilang maniwala. Kaya mga kapatid, kung titingnan natin ang ating mapagbasa ay angkop sa uri ng buhay ninyo mga magtatapos sa araw na ito. Kayo po ay magtatapos sa araw na ito at kayo ay makitungo kayo ngayon sa panibagong buhay na meron kayo. Pero tandaan ninyo, pagkatapos niyong umalis dito sa ASCOT, makakaranas kayo ng matinding uri ng buhay na inyong makikita sa inyong paglalakbay. Makakaranas kayo ng rejection. Makakaranas kayo ng mga trust issue na kung saan walang tiwala ang matao sa paligid ninyo sa iyo. Dito nyo ngayon mapapatunayan yung kakayahan na meron kayo. Dito ninyo makikita ngayon yung biyaya na meron tayo. Alam nyo, ang pinakamaganda na biyaya na meron tayo na pinakaloob ng Diyos, yung our capacity to dream. Patuloy tayong mangarap kahit ang mga tao sa paligid natin ay hindi naniniwala sa kakayahan natin. Pero tandaan ninyo, ang buhay na isinasabuhay natin ay hindi ito tungkol sa mga tao sa paligid natin. Tungkol ito sa sarili natin kung paano tayo magkaroon ng determinasyon sa ating pangarap. Kapag ang taong nangangarap, may maliwanag na kinabukasan na marating. Kaya huwag kayong huminto sa inyong pangarap. Tupdan ninyo at hangarin ninyo na makamit ang inyong mga pangarap sa buhay. Siyempre sa pangarap ninyo, tandaan ninyo, maraming mga pagkakataon na maraming hahadlang sa inyong pangarap. Pero maniwala kayo, magtiwala kayo na sa kabila ng inyong kahinaan, merong Diyos na laging gumagabay sa inyo at bibigyan kayo ng pagkakataon, bibigyan kayo ng kalakasan upang patuloy ninyong abutin ang mga pangarap na meron kayo. Sa totoo lang, kung meron man kayong isa sa pinakapasalamatan ninyo sa araw na ito, walang iba kundi ang mga magulang ninyo. Sila ang nag-alay ng kanilang sarili para sa inyo. At doon nyo makikita kung paano gumagalaw yung pag-ibig at pagmamahal ng Diyos. Sa pamagitan ng kanyang sakripisyo at hirap, nandito kayo ngayon, magtatapos. Pero ito ay isang panibagong hakbang lamang upang sa inyong pangarap. Pero anumat mangyari, nandyan ang inyong mamagulang. Suportahan at higit sa lahat, nakaalalay sa inyo. Kasi una't una, sila yung manilalang na unang nagtiwala at higit sa lahat, sila ay may pangarap din sa inyo. No? Kagabi, meron akong nabasang kwento. No? Kilala niya si Thomas Edison. Sino sa inyo dito hindi nakakilala kay Thomas Edison? Huwag na kayong mag-graduate. No? Kilala niyo si Thomas Edison? Yes or no? Wala, di nyo kilala. Doko, di niya kilala si Thomas, oh. Si Thomas Edison, siya yung nag-imbento ng ilaw, bumbilya. Mm. Isang araw, mayroong sulat na binigay ang teacher ni Thomas Edison sa kanya at sabi ng teacher, wag na wag mo itong bubuksan. Dapat sinanay mo lang ang magbukas nito. E di tuwang-tuwa si Thomas Edison. na sa grade school siya. Pagdating doon sa bahay niya, binigay niya sulat sa mama niya, at nung binuksan yung sulat, habang binabasa ng nanay niya, tumutulo ang luha ng nanay niya. Nagtaka ngayon si Thomas Edison, "Nanay, bakit ka umiiyak? Anong nilalaman ng sulat?" Sabi ng nanay ni Thomas Edison, "Anak, sinasabi dito sa may sulat na ito na simula daw bukas, di ka na papasok." "Ay, bakit po?" "Kasi anak, sabi ng teacher mo, napaka-genius mo daw. At wala silang kakayahan ngayon magturo sa'yo kasi lahat ng lesson na meron sila ay alam mo na." Sabi ni Thomas Edison, "Eh, paano yan, nanay? Gusto ko mag-aral." "Huwag ka mag-alala, anak. Simula bukas, ako na ang magiging teacher mo. Tuturuan kita." Sabi niya. Araw-araw, tinuruan si Thomas Edison ng nanay niya at laging sinasabi ng nanay niya, "Napakagaling ng anak ko. Napaka-genius ng anak ko." Hanggang naging scientist si Edison. At namatay ngayon ang nanay niya. Nung namatay ng nanay niya, pagkatapos ng libing, gusto ni Thomas Edison ayusin ang lahat ng gamit na meron ang nanay niya. Nung kanyang pagbukas ng drawer, nakita niya at naalala niya na yung envelope na yun, ito yung envelope na binigay ng teacher sa kanya nung grade school siya upang ipabasa sa nanay niya. Simula nung binasa ng nanay ang sulat niya, di niya nakikita yung sulat na yun kasi tinago pala ng nanay niya sa kanyang drawer na kung saan nakalak lagi. Nung binuksan na ngayon ni Thomas Edison ang sulat na iyon, laking gulat niya at sobrang iyak niya kasi ang nakalagay doon na sulat, sabi niya, sabi ng sulat ng teacher, "Dear Mrs. Edison, we regret to inform you that we no longer accept your child in our school because he is a mental retarded. Wala kaming kakayahan upang suportahan siya at turuan dahil siya ay autistic." Sobrang iyak ni Thomas Edison na sa kabila ng lahat, tinakwil siya ng eskwelahan na meron siya pero mayroong isang taong naniwala sa kanya. Walang iba kundi ang kanyang ina. Mga kapatid, papasok kayo sa panibagong yugto ng buhay niyo at tandaan ninyo kung ano man ang karanasan na makikita ninyo at ma-encounter ninyo, maniwala kayo lagi sa pangarap niyo dahil sa likod ng isang pangarap, merong sumusurta. Walang iba kundi ang inyong mga magulang. Iiwanan man kayo ng mga tao sa paligid ninyo, ng kaibigan ninyo, ng mga jowa ninyo, pero ang mga magulang nyo ay manatili sa inyo. Tandaan ninyo, maraming pagkakataon na nag-aantay sa inyo. Piliin ninyo lagi na tuparin ang pangarap ninyo sapagkat ang pangarap ninyo ay lagi nasa puso ninyo. No? Meron pag isang kwento ng isang obispo. No? Sabi niya nung bata siya, gusto niya lagi manalo sa palo-palayok. Alam niyo yung laro na palo-palayok? Kaso lang, hindi niya napapalo at lagi siyang binubuli kasi hindi niya matatamaan ang palayok. And then one time, may birthday party, nagpaalam itong bata na ito. Sabi niya, "Tatay, gusto ko sana pumunta sa birthday mamaya, pero gusto ko maglaro ng palo-palayok. Kaso lang, baka matalo na naman ako, pagtawanan nila ako." Sabi ng tatay niya, "Halika dito anak, ito yung sikreto. No? Mamaya, maglaro ka doon. Paghawak mo mamaya ng pamalo at kapag piniringan na ang mata mo, marami kang tinig na maririnig. May sisigaw na kaliwa, may sisigaw na kanan, may sisigaw na paluin mo na. Pero tandaan mo, huwag kang makinig. Makinig ka sa boses ko. Sa dami ng ingay mamaya, pakinggan mo lang ang boses ko. sigurado akong matatamaan mo ang palayok. No? Mga kapatid, paglabas nyo sa ASCOT, marami kayong tinig na maririnig. Marami kayong mga bagay-bagay na makikita. Pero kapag kayo, ang boses ng mga magulang ninyo, ng mga teacher ninyo, ng mga admin ng ASCOT nito, ay manatili sa puso nyo, di kayo maliligaw. Patungo sa pangarap nyo, makamtan nyo, magtiwala, manalig, at mananampalataya. Amen.
Please stand.
For every petition, let us pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For your church, may your Spirit lead us to live the gospel more fully, to be a sign to the world of your deep love for all, to herald justice and peace, and to be faithful to the truth. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace to resist temptation, open our minds and hearts to recognize our shortcomings and to rely on our inner holiness. Strengthen us to renounce earthly attractions, politics, greed, addictions, and falsehood as we move toward expanding horizons. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all humanity, may we respect your covenant with all living creatures by striving toward greatness stewardship of our natural resources, given for our good and for the sustenance of future generations. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Comfort and empower all who live with pain and anxiety, the poor, the homeless, the immigrant, the captive, those who suffer from illness or diseases, all who are trapped in fear and loneliness, all who confront death or struggle through grief, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring us through this desert time of Lent, renew our spirits and strengthen our faith so that we could embrace the essence of inclusiveness, resilience, and innovativeness in our professional journeys. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the season of Lent bring healing and renewal, bring us closer to you. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our personal intentions, we bring to mind in silence. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. All of this we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Please be seated and let us sing the offertory song.
Thank you.
pray, brethren, that our sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Grant, O merciful God, that we may be worthy to serve ever fittingly at your altars, that there be saved by constant participation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with yours.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just and our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. By your grace, gracious gift each year, your faithful await the sacred Paschal feast with a joy of minds made pure so that more eagerly intent on our prayer, on the works of charity and participating in the mysteries by which they have been reborn, they be believed to the fullness of grace and you bestowed your sons and daughters. And so the angels and archangels with thrones and the dominions and with a host of the prayers of heaven, we sing with your glory as without end as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of your holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them that dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that the world is worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Bernard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that partaking of the Blessed Virgin Mother, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to the course to eternal life. And we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen."
Brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's us offer each other the sign of peace. Brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and the soul shall be healed. Please be seated. For those who will be receiving the Holy Communion, please form two lines at the center.
Thank you.
Celebrate our joys in earning our diplomas today, loving Father, we thank you for your selfless love despite our sinfulness, for your divine wisdom and protection despite our insensitiveness, for the bountiful blessings of health and wealth despite our inconsciousness and extravagance, for lighting our path to righteousness despite our indifference, for the untiring care and support of our family despite our stubbornness. We also thank you for our alma mater, its management and employees, for the patience, commitment, and dedication to mold us in our chosen profession. Above all, we thank you for the bread of life we have received together in this Eucharistic celebration,
that will serve as spiritual reminders for us in expanding our horizons through our professional journeys. For all this, we pray, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Please stand.
Let us pray. May the unfailing protection of the sacrifice we have received never leave us, O Lord. And may it always drive far from us all that would do us harm through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My announcement. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Palakpakan natin ang Panginoon.
Umupo po ang lahat. We will have a short break after this baccalaureate mass conclusion. May we invite all of our graduates, guests, and participants to please settle down. We are about to begin our program. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Please settle down. Today, we gather here to celebrate the achievements of our graduates. Our theme for this year's ceremony is Expanding Horizons, celebrating inclusive, resilient, and innovative graduates, reflecting the values and aspirations of our institution and its graduates. As the baccalaureate mass concludes, we now transition to the commencement exercises. We would like to invite the academic deans, administrative heads, here on stage. Entering now is our college marshal and our academic deans. May I invite everybody to please rise as we welcome our guest of honor and commencement speaker, Honorable ROMMEL RICO T. ANGARA, together with our key college officials, our college president, Dr. Renato G. Reyes, and the vice presidents of the college, Vice President for Academic Affairs, Dr. Malus F. Kabatan, the Vice President for Planning, Administration, and Finance, Engineer Oscar Barawid, with our esteemed Board of Trustees. A big round of applause to our guest of honor, also the representative of the Loan District of Aurora. Good morning po and welcome. Please remain standing as the ASCOT NSTP ROTC presents the entrance of colors, followed by the national anthem.
Ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas. Thank you.
You may now take your seats. Once again, good morning and welcome to the 37th Commencement Exercises of Aurora State College of Technology. This year's theme, Expanding Horizons, Celebrating Inclusive, Resilient, and Innovative Graduates. We are now honored to have Dr. Maluzef Kabatan, the Vice President for Academic Affairs, who will now present the candidates for graduation.
Good morning. As the Vice President for Academic Affairs, I would like to inform the public that the students who are graduating today have been certified to have completed their academic requirements during the Academic Council meeting held on February 27, 2024. The registrar, the deans of the academic units, and members of the academic council have certified the requirements, and now the academic deans will present them to the college president. Let's start presenting our candidates.
Dr. Renato G. Reyes, College President, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for graduation of Aurora State College of Technology for academic year 2023 to 2024 for the following degrees. Three candidates for Master of Arts in Education, one candidate for Major in Educational Management, two candidates for Major in Guidance and Counseling, one candidate for Master of Science in Environmental Management, one candidate for Master of Science in Agriculture, Major in Animal Science, eight candidates for Master in Management, four candidates for Major in Business Management, four candidates for Major in Public Management, and three candidates for Certificate in Professional Education. They have satisfactorily completed all the requirements prescribed by the College and the Commission on Higher Education, and therefore, they are eligible for graduation with their corresponding degrees and titles.
Dr. Renato G. Reyes, College President, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for graduation of Aurora State College of Technology for academic year 2023-2024 for the following degrees. Eight candidates for Bachelor of Science in Agriculture, of which four are major in Animal Science, please rise, and four candidates for major in Crop Science, please rise. And one candidate for Bachelor of Science in Fisheries. They have satisfactorily completed all the requirements as prescribed by the Commission on Higher Education, and therefore they are eligible for graduation with their corresponding degrees and titles.
Dr. Renato G. Reyes, College President, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for graduation of Aurora State College of Technology for academic year 2023-2024 for the following degrees. 13 candidates for Bachelor of Science in Electrical Engineering, please rise. and 6 candidates for Bachelor of Science in Mechanical Engineering. They have satisfactorily completed all the requirements as prescribed by the Commission on Higher Education, and therefore, they are eligible for graduation with their corresponding degrees and titles.
Dr. Renato G. Reyes, College President, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for graduation of Aurora State College of Technology for academic year 2023-2024 for the degree. 8 candidates for Bachelor of Science in Forestry. Please rise. They have satisfactorily completed all the requirements as prescribed by the College and the Commission of Higher Education, and therefore they are eligible for graduation with their corresponding degrees and titles.
Dr. Renato G. Reyes, College President, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for graduation of Aurora State College of Technology for academic year 2023-2024 for the degree of a Bachelor of Science in Hospitality Management. Please rise. They have satisfactorily completed all the requirements as prescribed by the College and the Commission on Higher Education, and therefore, they are eligible for graduation with their corresponding degrees and titles.
Dr. Renato G. Reyes, College President, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for graduation of the Aurora State College of Technology for academic year 2023-2024 for the following degrees. 12 candidates for major in Automotive Engineering Technology, please rise. 1 candidate for major in Civil Engineering Technology, please rise. 11 candidates for major in Electrical Engineering Technology, please rise. And 6 candidates for major in Food Technology. They have satisfactorily completed all the requirements as prescribed by the College and the Commission on Higher Education, and therefore they are eligible for graduation with their current degrees and titles.
Dr. Renato G. Reyes, College President, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for graduation of Aurora State College of Technology for academic year 2023-2024 for the degree. 7 candidates for Associate in Computer Technology. They have satisfactorily completed all the requirements as prescribed by the College and the Commission on Higher Education, and therefore, they are eligible for graduation with their corresponding degrees and titles.
Dr. Renato G. Reyes, College President, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for graduation of Aurora State College of Technology for school year 2023-2024 for the degree. 1 candidate for Diploma in Forest Technology. He has satisfactorily completed all the requirements as prescribed by the College and the Commission on Higher Education, and therefore, they are eligible for graduation with the corresponding degrees and titles.
Thank you to our deans for the conferment of degrees, our college president, Dr. Renato G. Reyes.
By virtue of the authority vested upon me by the Commission on Higher Education and the Board of Trustees of Aurora State College of Technology, as per Resolution Number 7, Series of 2024, and with the presentation and certification by the respective school deans and the Vice President for Academic Affairs, that these 99 candidates for graduation have satisfactorily completed the higher education curriculum prescribed by the Commission on Higher Education, I hereby confirm their graduation, and therefore they are entitled to receive certificates and diplomas and to enjoy whatever benefits appertaining thereto. Congratulations and mabuhay.
Thank you, President Renato G. Reyes. To tell us more about our guest of honor and commencement speaker, allow me once again to invite our college president, Dr. Renato G. Reyes. Let's put our hands together for our president.
We are honored today to welcome in our institution a man who has been supporting ASCOT since day one. He is currently on his second term as the representative of the Lone District of Aurora, the vice chairperson of the Committee on Tourism and Committee on Aquaculture and Fisheries of the House of Representatives. He is also consistently hailed for two consecutive years as top performing representative in the Central Aurora, securing the top three spot among 23 representatives in Region 3. Not only did he support the infrastructure projects of our great institution, but he also authored House Bill Number 5892, converting ASCOT to a university, provided numerous financial assistances to the faculty and non-faculty, and scholarships to our students. On a final note, he is a good-looking congressman of the Lone Province of Aurora. Please join me in welcoming a hard-working and passionate leader, Honorable Congressman ROMMEL T. ANGARA.
Maraming salamat. Maupo na po tayo. First and foremost, ako po ay nagagalak at natutuwa sapagkat ngayong araw na ito, ako po ay parte ng exercises ngayong araw na ito. And before I start, I'd like to be perfectly honest. Nung ako po ay inimbita ni President Renato Reyes, siguro nakasampung beses akong sinabi ko sa kanya na, President, I am not available on that date. Because I wanted my people, yung aking mga kalalawigan, na baka nagsasawa na sa akin, ay gusto ko naman makarinig ng bagong ideya from other persons. But President was very, very persistent. Nakailang sangga na ako, nakailang hindi na ako. Pinuntahan pa niya ako sa bahay ko. Hindi ko alam kung paano niya ako natsyempohan. But then again, nung ako ay nakita niya at face to face na, eye to eye, ako ay tinititigan niya, Congressman, kailan available ng date mo? I had no choice. I had to be here. At sabi ko nga sa aking sarili, this is a sign that I like. Gustong gusto ko po yun. Bakit? Kasi it shows that he is persistent. If the new president of ASCOT may convincing persistency, palagay ko marayo o marami tayong magagawa para sa ating state college sa mga darating na panahon. So with that, gusto pong i-acknowledge our college president, palakpakan po natin, si President Renato Reyes. To the Academic Council, to each and everybody who's present today, to the graduates, sa mga magulang, sa ating mga tumutulong dito po sa Aurora State College of Technology, magandang, magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. As starters, sa ating mga graduates, tapos na ang mga grado, tapos na ang mga lectures, meron na kayo maya-maya ng inyong mga matagal nang minimithiing diploma. In other cases, sa mga masterals, kumpleto na. Isa na lang ang kailangan ninyong gawin bago nyo ito matanggap. At yan ay makinig sa akin ng panandalian at makukuha nyo na ang inyong matagal nang minimithi. When I was growing up, I grew up in Baler. Back and forth, Manila, balik ng Baler, as I've always been. Lahat po tayo here, we all have dreams. Lahat tayo may pangarap. Sa akin, growing up, it was just very, very simple. Kahit ako noon ay nag-aaral sa Maynila nung elementarya, high school, all the way to college, I knew it in my heart that I will always live or go back to my hometown in Baler, in Aurora province. Dito po sa atin, sa lahat ng aking nakakausap, in all walks of life, they always love our hometown of Baler, our province of Aurora. Lahat kayo, mga graduates, excelled, matataas ang grades in your courses, in your masterals. You've worked tremendously. You've worked so hard for the time that you are here right now. Napakahirap, maraming sakripisyo, maraming mga ginawa para maatim ninyo ang inyong maatim ngayong araw na ito. But my very, very most important message in my experience growing up and being now even as one of the leaders of our province, tandaan po natin ang pinaka-importante na ginagawa po natin or our own very, very existence in life. Minsan, sa dami nating ginagawa sa ating trabaho, ay minsan ay nakakaligtaan natin yung pinaka-importante, which is making sure that you have time for the people you love and living life itself per se. Ibig sabihin, ngayong araw na ito, pagkatapos na ito, maghahanap tayo ng trabaho, opportunities, businesses, or even go back for promotion in some other cases. This is, lahat po tayo nangangailangan ng income or source of living. But kinakailangan ito ay hindi magsasakripisyo ang inyong oras sa inyong mga mahal sa buhay, and kinakailangan you have a clear vision of what you want in life. I have basically lived here sa ating probinsya. Lahat po tayo may pinagdaanan at some point in our lives. When I was mid-20s, mid-30s, I was almost about to give up. About to give up dahil sa tingin ko na hindi ko po na-achieve yung aking gusto sa buhay. But when I became there, I realized that not only working should always be first or priority, ang pinaka-importante ay ini-enjoy mo kung ano yung gagawin mo at ano yung gagawin mo pa sa mga susunod na kabanata. Life is simple. Gusto mo magkapamilya ka, gusto mo magkaroon ka ng trabaho, gusto mong magkaroon ka ng mga anak na over time you will nourish and cherish. Pagdating ng panahon, yan, gaganda ang buhay mo. Life is very simple. Pero at the end of the day, as all humans do, it's always human nature that there's always conflicts sa trabaho, sa eskwelahan, at even sa pamilya. Pero I've always lived up to a basic thought na lagi kong gustong i-implement sa aking buhay that I'd like to share with the fresh graduates ngayong araw na ito. Sa aking daily schedule, napakahirap po. Parang this week lang po, kaya ako po tinatanggihan si President Renato Reyes. I came from Congress. I went home by 11 p.m. I slept by 2:30 a.m. traveled 4:30 a.m. back to Baler because I had some inaugurations, meeting schedules. Minsan, iniisip ko sa sarili ko, ay sulit pa ba yung ginagawa ko? Kasi minsan, katulad ngayong araw na ito, ay schedule ng prom ng aking panganay. Earlier, before I left, umagang-umaga, kahit puyat na puyat po ako, ay tinawagan ko yung aking anak na ako ay humihingi ng paumanhin. Because last year, I told him, anak, this is your prom. I will never, ever miss it for the world. Again, it is the first time that I broke a promise to him. Because growing up, just a little information, baka magulat po kayo, that I was the one among our siblings, tatlo po kami magkakapatid, that never wanted or even dreamt of being in politics. Why? Because when my father was mayor from 1978 to 1988 here in Baler, when I was studying in Manila, sa Kuleyo San Agustin, Makati, hindi po siya naka-attend ni isang graduation ko because during those times, yung travel time from Baler to Manila was I think 12 to 14 hours. Then I made a promise to myself. Sabi ko, pag ako ay tumanda, ako ay lumaki, sisiguraduhin ko na lahat ng momentous events ng aking mga magiging anak ay hindi ako mawawala. So I try to do my best, but sometimes, kagaya ngayong araw na ito, ay hindi talaga maiiwasan. What I'm pushing here, what I'm seeing here to the graduates, magandang maganda na ngayon ay na-achieve nyo na ang inyong kagustuhan and probably the direction in life that you will go into. But my main message is make sure to make time to the people that you love and cherish. Because again, life is very, very short. My hashtag in life is always good vibes. Marami po akong problema, araw-araw. Problema ko, problema ng iba. I have to suck it in and make sure that I at least resolve those issues, those problems. But before I entered to the position or even bago ko inalok yung aking sarili na maging isang congressman na lalawigan, I knew already that for a fact. Alam ko na yon, and I'm ready for the challenge. Sa ating mga graduates ngayon, siguradong marami kayo mga challenges at hand. You will not always be happy every day kasi may mga problema nga yan. But then again, how to choose your live your life is an option and a freedom that bears us all. Lagi kong sinasabi sa aking sarili na tuwing to be able to be stay grounded, because at the end of the day, I will never be a congressman for life and hindi ko po pinapangarap yon. I will just be here in a temporary basis. Kinakailangan, mga graduates, and to the people who are here, this is the quote that I always live by. I always work hard, stay humble, and the most important is always to be kind. Kindness may not change the world, pero if you show a person on that special or even for just one day, it might change his life or perspective sa kanyang buhay. Dito po sa ating probinsya, siguro po unti-unti ay nakikita natin yung kaunting pagbabago. On the barangay levels, on the municipal levels, I am proud to report that we are almost 85% na na-achieve na po natin in my 10-year development plan for our province. Our airport, finally, is now being done. Our all road networks leading to provinces, leading to all towns, matatapos na po yan. Lahat ng tulay, 18 na malalaki na sa umpisa ay akala ko ay pangarap lamang para magkonekta ang ating mga probinsya at the same time ang ating mga bayan nandyan na. We're building health centers, dialysis centers, munisipyo, so on and so forth. I think this year, Mr. President and the ASCOT, we should focus, or I, together with you, working hand in hand. That's the reason na sinabi ko pong gusto ko pong persistent si President Renato Reyes, is I think we should concentrate together me and I, Senator Sunny, sa mga pangangailangan ng ating minamahal na ASCOT para kahit papano ay mabigyan natin ng quality of education ang ating mga estudyante. And I would like to begin, kanina nga po, pagpasok ko, pag-upo ko doon, binibiro ko si President. President, sa tagal ng panahon na aking pag-aalala, pag ako po ay may formal occasion sa Aurora Province, the last time I wore o nagsuot ako ng long barong was I think 2016, 8 years ago. Sabi ko sa kanya, sinadya niya ata talagang ipaalala sa akin na ako ay mag-long barong para ako ay mainitan ngayong araw. Kasi pagkapasok na pagkapasok ko pa lang, sabi niya, Sir, ito po yung aking isa sa mga priority ng ASCOT dahil ito ang nagsasabing mukha ng ASCOT. And ang sabi ko naman sa kanya, Sir, I was not born yesterday. Alam ko na ang pinupunto mo. Pero ganun pa man, Aurora is a small province in terms of population. Napakaliit po natin. In terms of land, tayo po ay pangalawa sa pinakamalaki sa Region 3. And hindi naman po sa pagmamayabang o pagmamalaki ng ating probinsya, ay wala pa po akong nakiusap na congressman o governor o mayor na galing sa ibang lugar na hindi pumuri sa ating lalawigan ng Aurora. Pero ang lagi kong sinasabi sa kanila na talagang napakaganda ng Aurora. Pero ang pinakamaningning sa aming lalawigan, kaunti kami, karamihan magkakamag-anak pa, pero ang pinakapinagmamalaki ko dyan, yes, maganda ang aming mga tanawin, maganda ang aming mga beaches, pero ang pinaka-importante dyan, magaganda ang mga ugali ng aking mga kalalawigan dito po sa ating lalawigan ng Aurora. Bayaan nyo na po yun sa politika. Ganun po talaga yan. Politics is a different level. Pero at least dito naman po, it remains at peace, it remains at that. But going back to the developments of ASCOT, to the Academic Council, to the students, to the parents, to the faculty, the teaching personnel, forgive me, paumanhin po. But this year, hindi na po akong papayag na hindi ko matututukan ang ASCOT pertaining doon sa mga pangangailangan ninyo. In fact, the reason na I turned this down, President, sana itong ating graduation is because I have so many things to do. Mamaya po, I have a schedule in 1 o'clock in Municipio, but today, hindi po pwedeng, hindi po tayo mag-uusap again, President, because our job in Congress has already started pertaining to the budget. Ayoko na po yung nakagawian natin na sa huli lang natin aalamin kung ano yung kailangan ng ASCOT. I've found a solution na kung saan maaga pa lang mailalagay na natin yung mga pangailangan ng ASCOT. One, the first, very first priority, Mr. President, is the classrooms. Ngayong taon pong ito, mayroon po tayong mga nilagay na karagdagan na classrooms. But in the General Appropriations Act of 2024 of this year, it will be no longer implemented by ASCOT. It will be implemented by DPWH para ito po ay siguraduhin matatapos at magagawa po natin. But as per information of Mr. President, yung mailalagay po natin mga classrooms ay kulang pa. Over the years, I've talked to your professors, the Academic Council, napakarami pa natin kailangan. And to answer your question, Mr. President, isama na po natin ito. In my thought, because tama ka po, lahat ng events, schedulings ng ASCOT, lahat po dito ginagawa. As per your information or for the information of President, binigyan ko po siya ng example kanina sa bayan ng Baler, kung naalala po niyo yung sports complex. Ni-repair ko po yun, nilagyan natin ng pondo, it was parang ganito rin po yung situation niya. But it will be up to you guys kung gusto niyo ipa-aircon itong inyong gymnasium. Kasi kayo ang magbabayad ng kuryente, hindi ako. But if you ask me, personally, may pagkakataon ka na eh. Ngayon kung may aircon ka, kung ayaw mong gamitin, huwag mo buksan. Pero kung may aircon ka at sobrang init, katulad ng mga future events mo, buksan mo. And I would like, gusto ko ang ASCOT, green technology. I've been building multipurpose halls or barangay halls or evacuation centers all over Aurora. And ito po ay green, meaning solar powered, and at the same time, it is backed up by generators. Sabi ko nga, pagkatapos nito, Mr. President, yung meeting natin last month, if I'm not mistaken. And verbatim, sinabi ko po sa inyo, I will give you 3 weeks. Tama. I will give you 3 weeks to pass to me yung lahat ng pangangailangan ng ASCOT. As I remember it correctly, that was TOPS priorities 1 to 5. Mamaya po, kailangan ko na yung priority 1 to 3 mo. Kasi bukas, I'm not kidding, kasi bukas, I will already submit it to the Appropriations Committee which I belong to. I have the privilege, yun po ang pribilehiyo ng ikaw ay nasa Finance Committee sa Kongreso. Sa Senado, hindi po ako nangangamba kasi meron po tayong taga-Aurora ang chairman ng Finance. Pero ngayon po, iba na po yung gagawin natin. Sapagkat ngayon pa lang po, sabi ko nga po sa inyo, hindi na po ako papayag, aagahan ko na po yung paglagay ng mga pangangailangan ng ating minamahal na ASCOT. Inamin ko po kay President, kanina sa pagpakilala niya po sa akin, I authored yes, yung pagiging eventually na maging university ang ASCOT. I admitted to him and to the people who was with him during that meeting na pinapahold ko muna ito. Pinapahold in the sense na gusto ko it will run its course, pero before we reach that universityhood, gusto ko prepared physically sa ating mga pangangailangan ang ating minamahal na ASCOT. And sa lahat naman po ng aking mga binabanggit, I tell you right now to the graduates, to the students, to the faculty, that hindi po ako titigil hanggat hindi ko magagawa yung mga pangangailangan ng ating Aurora State College of Technology. And with that being said, I will not bore you with a very, very long speech. Nung kagabi, nung natapos na po yung lahat ng aking mga kausap, I think I had 10 to 11 meetings, mga around 11 p.m. ng gabi, I was thinking kung anong pwede kong iregalo dun sa mga graduates. Okay lang ba, Ms. President? Wala naman problema, di ba? Ha? Hindi mo naman ako pagbabawalan, di ba? Meron sana akong gimmick na gagawin. Unfortunately, hindi siya umabot. But nevertheless, siguro ibibigay ko na lang kay President, o mamaya kung umabot, aabot naman siya, huwag kayong magalala. A simple token of my gratitude. Kasi ako, pagkatapos mamaya nitong inyong ng ating graduation rites, tayo po ay magkakaroon ng simpleng salo-salo with your loved ones. As your congressman, as your representative, to show my gratitude and appreciation and to wish you good luck on your endeavors in life, ay meron po akong kaunting regalo. Kunin niyo na lang po doon sa chief of staff ko na hanggang ngayon ay wala pa siyang kamuang-muang. So Ayla, pag hindi ko ibigay sa iyo, abunohan mo muna. And sa aking pagkatapos, I will move here in the middle. Nung aking pag-uumpisa sa aking speech, sinabi ko lang po na ako ay simpleng bata na galing ng Baler. Sa pagtatapos nyo ngayong araw na ito, simple na naman po ang aking hihilingin sa inyo. You are now expert in your fields. Marami kayong mararating and hopefully, you will find your purpose in life. But bago po ako magtapos, may isa po akong hihilingin sa inyong mga graduates ngayong araw na ito, na sana ay tumatak o lumusot sa inyong mga puso. Marami kayong mararating sa inyong buhay over time. But ang aking pakiusap, kung kahit papaano ay mababalik mo na tulong, not in cash, but in kind, ang inyong maliit na mga bayan ang inyong maliit at magandang lalawigan, sana po ibalik ninyo sa ang pagmamahal sa ating minamahal na lalawigan ng Aurora. Congratulations! Maraming maraming salamat po.
Thank you very much to our guest of honor and commencement speaker, Honorable ROMMEL RICO T. ANGARA. Maraming maraming salamat po for your kindness and generosity. God bless you more. Again, a big round of applause to our guest of honor and commencement speaker. With that, may we request you to be on the center stage as we give you a plaque of recognition. Allow me to... Republic of the Philippines, Aurora State College of Technology, Baler, Aurora. This plaque of recognition is hereby awarded to Honorable ROMMEL RICO T. ANGARA, Representative, Lone District of Aurora, House of Representatives, for sharing his invaluable words of wisdom as guest of honor and commencement speaker on the occasion of the 37th commencement exercises of the Aurora State College of Technology. With the theme, Expanding Horizons, Celebrating Inclusive, Resilient, and Innovative Graduates. And in grateful recognition of his commitment and dedication by sharing his meaningful ideas which will serve as guiding principles for the graduating class of first semester, school year 2023-2024, awarded the second day of March 2024 at ASCOT, Baler, Aurora. Signed by Renato G. Reyes, College President. Again, thank you very much, Honorable ROMMEL ANGARA. Congratulations din sa ating mga graduates. Now, the moment you have all been waiting for, the fruit of hard work and discipline will finally be reaped. You will be receiving your prize's diploma, a symbol of your victorious accomplishments. And with that, may we request also the Board of Trustees, the academic directors, our guest speaker, our key college officials to be on the center stage for the imposition of hoods and awarding of diplomas for the graduates. We'll begin with the imposition of hoods and awarding of diplomas to our graduates. Let's have the graduates and the parents or their spouses. And the academic deans. Master of Arts in Education, Major in Educational Management. Manzano Reynaldo Jr. F. of Barangay Diteki, San Luis, Aurora. Please join also them, guest of honor, Honorable ROMMEL. Would you like to join also? Major in Guidance and Counseling, Bernardo Noemi Ruth M. of Barangay Zara, San Luis, Aurora. Mm-hmm. Gymnasium, Mary Joy Z of Barangay Pingit, Baler, Aurora. She is also the best in comprehensive exam. Master of Science in Agriculture. Major in Animal Science, Bumatay Valin D. of Barangay Reserva, Baler, Aurora. Master in Management, Major in Business Management, Beronilia Rose Ann A. of Barangay Suklayin, Baler, Aurora. She's also best in comprehensive exam. Master of Science in Environmental Management, Tore Lizalinda I of Barangay Kulat, Kasiguran, Aurora. Best in Thesis. Master in Management, Major in Business Management. Pascua Eileen M. of Barangay Pingit, Baler, Aurora. Susan L. of BF Resort Village, Las Piñas. Valdez Navan Chris G. of Barangay North Poblacion, Dipakulaw, Aurora. Major in Public Management, Cabana, Ederlene J. of Barangay 5, Baler, Aurora. Hermine Hildo, Louis R., Barangay Buhangin, Baler, Aurora. Morillo Rose Ann R. of Barangay Zabali, Baler, Aurora. Suavardes Maria Cristina G., Barangay 3, Baler, Aurora. For the non-degree post-baccalaureate program, Certificate in Professional Education. Pelaez Johan Rufo B. of Barangay San Isidro, San Luis, Aurora. Rabago Jeneline G. of Barangay Ipil, Dipakulao, Aurora. Romero Marjorie L. Barangay Zabali, Baler, Aurora. Congratulations, and also thank you to our school dean, Jay Amon. Next, the Bachelor of Science in Agriculture with their dean, Mark Rafael. Abrero Limrol C. of Barangay Reserva, Baler, Aurora. Ariola Charlu G. of Barangay Reserva, Baler, Aurora, also an athlete awardee. Ora, Kevin Carl S., Barangay Bazal, Maria, Aurora, Aurora. Valenzuela, Charlene M., Barangay Reserva, Baler, Aurora. For the Bachelor of Science in Agriculture, major in Crop Science. Mota Danica A., Barangay Bayanihan, Maria Aurora Aurora. Rabaha Charlotte M. of Barangay Pingit, Baler, Aurora. Mm-hmm. Valmoha Steven Zor L. of Barangay Abuleg, Dinalungan, Aurora. Wenceslao Francis James S., Barangay Abuleg, Dinalungan, Aurora. Bachelor of Science in Fisheries, Redula Angelie L. of Barangay Calabgan, Kasiguran, Aurora. Next, the Bachelor of Science in Electrical Engineering graduates, please join us with their school dean, Dean Amarlo A. Banana. Almogela Fredeline T. of Barangay Manggatihan, Dilasag, Aurora. Amatorio Aurora Q. Barangay Bacong, San Luis, Aurora. Bernardes John Leno T. of Barangay Nonong Senor, San Luis, Aurora. Crisanto Mary Therese Pauline G. of Barangay Obligacion, Baler, Aurora. Donella Vincent O. of Barangay Diteki, San Luis, Aurora. Gutierrez Mark Taverns J. Barangay Reserva, Baler, Aurora. La Chica, Michael Dave M., Barangay Lipit, Dipakulaw, Aurora. Kerihero, Jane Sol M., Barangay Dibayabay, San Luis, Aurora. Riopta Roger Mark E., Barangay San Isidro, San Luis, Aurora. Ringor Noel Jr. E., Barangay Ditaylen, Maria Aurora, Aurora. Ritual Wirlo M. of Barangay Buhangin, Baler, Aurora. Rodolfo Benedict T. Barangay Bianwan, Kasiguran, Aurora. Sindak Lance Joshua 8 of Barangay 2, Baler, Aurora. Moving on to the Bachelor of Science in Mechanical Engineering, Asuncion Andre Nielson P., Barangay Baskaran, Solano, Nueva Vizcaya. Fajardo Zerica of Barangay Ditumabo, San Luis, Aurora. Flores Alexandria L.B., Barangay Suklain, Baler, Aurora. Gonzales Loxley P. of Barangay Pingit, Baler, Aurora. Labsan, Junebert B. of Barangay Kabitokulan West, Maria Aurora, Aurora. Polistico Riza May L., Barangay Nonong Senyor, San Luis, Aurora. Moving on to the Bachelor of Science in Forestry with their Dean, Dr. RBJ Gallego. Cabrito Janelle A. of Barangay Zara, San Luis, Aurora. Cordova RJS of Barangay Dimabuno, Dipaculao, Aurora. Isidro Mark Ives C., Barangay Suklain, Baler, Aurora. Lanzanita Jen Alvin V. of Barangay Kabitokulan East, Maria Aurora, Aurora. Pastor Alona Jean Q., Barangay Ditumabo, San Luis, Aurora. Kerihero and Princess Lay A. of Barangay Pingit, Baler, Aurora. Lanzanita Jen Alvin V. of Barangay Kabitokulan East, Maria Aurora, Aurora. Kerihero and Princess Lay A. of Barangay Pingit, Baler, Aurora. Soridor Jonalyn G. of Barangay Sabang, Baler, Aurora. Tanghal Riza May V. of Barangay Nonong Senyor, San Luis, Aurora. Up next, our graduates of the Bachelor of Science in Hospitality Management with their Dean, Dean Malu C. Angara. Badwa Raymark V. of Barangay Wenceslao, Maria Aurora, Aurora. Balbuena Reynold G. of Barangay Ramada, Maria Aurora Aurora. Emperador Angela O. Barangay Dimanpudso, Maria Aurora Aurora. Fernandez Kate Deborah M. of Barangay 1, San Luis Aurora. Laroya Joaquin Andre G. of Barangay Wenceslao Maria Aurora Aurora. Cum laude. Napoles Crystal May H. of Barangay Sabang Baler Aurora. Santa Maria Beverly Ann O. of Barangay Ditumabo, San Luis Aurora. Tolentino Dan Cedric F. of Barangay Zabali, Baler Aurora. Next are the graduates of Bachelor in Industrial Technology, Major in Automotive Engineering Technology, with their school dean, Annie R. Capin. Aguilar, Aldrin M. of Barangay Ditinagyan, Kasiguran, Aurora. Kanyada Christian P. of Barangay Dibet, Kasiguran, Aurora. Kuritana Benjamin N. of Poblacion Zone 1, Dinalungan, Aurora. De Castro, Mikael Jordan C., Barangay Bianwan, Kasiguran, Aurora. Dulawan, J.R.M., Barangay Dibutunan, Dipakulaw, Aurora. Espiritu Justin Andrew V. of Barangay Bianwan, Kasiguran, Aurora. Furio Duvan V. of Barangay Quirino, Maria Aurora, Aurora. Makasa, John Paul O. of Barangay Dibet, Kasiguran, Aurora. Marquez, Mel John C. of Barangay Salay, Dipakulaw, Aurora. Santos, Emilia G., Barangay Suklayin, Baler, Aurora. Valencia Alfred G. of Barangay Bianuan, Kasiguran, Aurora. Verial Erwin O. of Barangay 2, Maria Aurora, Aurora. Major in Civil Engineering Technology. Berdine John Carlo Q. of Barangay Dimanayat, San Luis, Aurora. Major in Electrical Technology, Gonzales Ronald C. of Barangay Tayabo, San Jose City, Nueva Ecija. Major in Electrical Engineering Technology, Amazona Jeboy R. of Barangay Zara, San Luis, Aurora. Avila Noriel R. of Barangay Sabang, Baler, Aurora. Bahado Leo V. of Barangay Dipakong, Kasiguran, Aurora. Bautista John Som F. of Barangay Jagian, Dilasag, Aurora. Kapay-Kapay John Paul D.R. of Poblacion 6, Kasiguran, Aurora. Cruz Via V. Barangay San Isidro, San Luis, Aurora. Depalco John Kiel T. of Barangay Pingit, Baler, Aurora. Gutierrez Ria G. Barangay San Isidro, San Luis, Aurora. Look Mark Jeffrey C. Barangay Bianuan, Kasiguran, Aurora. Palima Jomar S. of Barangay Calabuanan, Baler, Aurora. Solina Ray Brian M. Barangay Digumased Dinapige, Isabela. Major in Food Technology. Alcantara Carl Angelo C. of Barangay Suklain, Baler, Aurora. Jake Jacob, Princess Diane M. of Barangay Buhangin, Baler, Aurora. Lopez Jamel N., Barangay Suklain, Baler, Aurora. Rojas Jeneline S. of Barangay Kulat, Kasiguran, Aurora. Sabado Neka B. of Barangay Obligacion, Baler, Aurora. Valle Elsa R. of Barangay Sabang, Baler, Aurora. Last but definitely not the least, our graduates and Associate in Computer Technology. Let's have the School Dean, Dr. Myrene V. Amazona. Fajardo John Wisam V. of Barangay Suklain, Baler, Aurora. Fernandez Iron G. of Barangay 4, Baler, Aurora. Flores VJT of Poblacion Zone 2, Dinalungan, Aurora. Galindo Stephen Ray C. of Barangay Pingit, Baler, Aurora. Galindo Stephen Ray C. of Barangay Pingit, Baler, Aurora. Navarro Janice D. Barangay Nonong Senior, San Luis, Aurora. Pasqua April Rose A. of Barangay San Joaquin, Maria, Aurora. Puyat Leilan Rachelin T. of Barangay Buhangin, Baler, Aurora. And for the Diploma in Forest Technology, I'd like to call once again Reyes Marie T. of Barangay Puangi, Dipakulao, Aurora. Congratulations once again to all of our graduates and special awardees. We are indeed so proud of your achievements. Apart from receiving your diploma, in a while, Honorable ROMMEL ANGARA has prepared a gift for everyone, for all of our graduates rather. I thought including myself. Congratulations, guys! Maraming salamat po, Congressman ROMMEL T. ANGARA. Evidently before this morning, very generous po ang ating mahal na congressman. Blessing indeed. Enjoy your celebrations with your family and friends. Wow! Magkita-kita po tayo? Saan mang restaurant? Sa Playa Azul. Kidding aside, let's now proceed with our program. I know we got all excited for this. Maraming salamat ulit, Congressman Romel. And to give the words of gratitude on behalf of the graduates of ASCOT Mid-Year 2023-2024, may I call on Joaquin Andre G. Laroya, cum laude.
My sincerest and deepest gratitude goes to ASCOT College Honors Awards Council for giving me this great opportunity to stand and speak here in behalf of my fellow graduates. To the distinguished commencement speaker and guest of honor, Honorable ROMMEL RICO T. ANGARA. To the college president, Dr. Renato G. Reyes. To our vice president for academic affairs, Dr. Malus F. Kabatan. The Vice President for Administration, Planning and Finance, Dr. Oscar C. Barawit Jr. The Honorable Members of the Board of Trustees, the Academic Council, the College Administrators, Faculty and Staff, Guests, Parents, Friends, and my fellow graduates, a pleasant morning. Today, as we gather here to celebrate this commencement exercise, I want to share with you a message of resilience, determination, and the power of dreams. Life is full of obstacles and conditions that makes us feel like giving up. But we survive because we always remember that our dreams and aspirations are not just for ourselves, but also for our families. My journey of being here as a graduate began just like the other graduates who dreamed that someday I would make it. It was in my elementary days when I started my journey and where I learned to earn money. Living in a penurious family, I have experienced my share of struggles way back then. Pumupunta po ako sa bukid, kasama ko po yung tita ko na si Auntie Marilyn, para lamang po manguha ng mga tulia o kaya lamang po ay bundok o kaya suso at mga pako. At ito po ay aming binebenta pag-uwi namin ng hapon sa halagang 10 piso po sa isang supot at tali. Ang aking kinikita dito ay ginagamit ko upang pangbaon sa eskwelahan at ang mga hindi naman nabenta ay siyang aming magiging ulam. As I reach high school, tumutulong naman po ako sa aking mga pinsan, kila Ate Rosel at Ate Gobi sa kanilang bakery. Nagtitinda ako sa aming barangay ng pandesal at donut. 10% ng aking napagtindahan ang siyang aking kinikita. Ako din ang nagbabantay sa kanilang tindahan at nagtitinda din ng mga fishball, kwek-kwek at iba pa. Ang mga kinikita ko dito ay pinandadagdag ko sa baon sa eskwelahan. It was also during this time where my first heartbreak happens. Namatayan po ako ng matalik na kaibigan. Dahil sa kanyang pagkawala, madaming nabago sa aking buhay. Nabarkada ako, natutong mag-inom, pati na rin manigarilyo. And then, when I entered senior high school, tuwing summer, ay nagpupunta naman ako sa aking Auntie Marta sa Manila upang tumulong sa kanilang patahian. Nagkakating po ako ng mga tela, nagbubuhat ng rolyo-rolyong tela, at nagbabaliktad ng mga natahing punda ng unan. At ako din ang nagbabantay sa kanilang tindahan. Ang perang aking kinita dito ay siyang aking pinangbili ng aking first ever touchscreen na cellphone, which is yung Flare S1 na Cherry Mobile. In my college years, I overcome many obstacles. When I was in my first year as an English major student, I found it difficult to continue my course. I felt that I wasn't working hard and not striving enough to excel in my course. And that is when I decided to shift to another course, and that is hospitality management. Having no idea about the new course, I still decided to choose hospitality management, which would later be the course that I started to love and embrace. In my second year in college, I started working while studying. COVID-19 came and affected much of my family's life. My father lost his job. This was then the condition that I decided to work. Given the changes in classes from face-to-face to online, I decided to work as a job order at the office of the provincial prosecutor, Aurora. I worked from my second year to my fourth year to help my family with financial needs and to support my education. My papa, a devoted farmer and carpenter, needed to work in Manila when my sister entered college to meet our family's increasing financial needs. My papa needed to work till midnight to put a lot of effort into supporting the family. His constant dedication and hard labor motivated me to keep going and study hard. My mother worked as a maid who put in a lot of overtime to enable her three children to go to school. Her courage and fortitude have inspired me throughout my life. However, my heart was broken witnessing my beloved mother battling against psoriasis, a chronic skin condition. Having this chronic illness, she still needed to work overtime for the children to send all of them to school. In the hospitality management department, I found my true self. I discovered a place that boosted my confidence and is aligned with my interests. This career walked me to what I truly wanted to be in life. I found myself becoming more productive and growing and have that fire in my heart to push myself in the industry. Those experiences taught me the importance of resilience and determination in pursuing my dreams. They enlightened me and made me realize that we have the power within us to face and overcome challenges, make bold decisions, and find our true passion in life. I am very grateful to Ma'am Zinaida A. Exclamado, who warmly welcomed me to the School of Arts and Sciences. Her support and belief in my ability made a huge impact throughout my journey. Her advice allowed me to do more and be better. To Dean Malusi Angara, I am very grateful for your support. Thank you for fighting for me to be here. Your dedication and passion for your work inspire many of your students. Thank you so much, ma'am. I'd also like to grab this opportunity to thank my favorite instructors, Sir Roberto Rivera and Ma'am Arlene Dulay. Sir Roberto, your advice and mentoring helped shape who I am today. Thank you for all your help, sir. To Ma'am Arlene, thank you, ma'am, for believing in me and seeing my potential beyond the volleyball field. Your words of wisdom, encouragement, and help made a huge impact on my academic and personal development. To the Office of the Provincial Prosecutor family, thank you for treating me not as your employee, but rather as part of your family. I owe a lot from all of you, ma'am and sir. Thank you for all the help, advice, and considerations. To my amazing friends, Jethro, Ernesto, and Raymark, thank you for always being there for me and having such positivity in life. The memories we've created together, the fun and the support we've shared have brought me to where I am right now. To my family, mama, papa, and my sisters, I am very grateful for your constant support. Thank you for all the sacrifices you have made for me. You believe in me and encouragement has been the driving force on every road I take. I am beyond blessed to have you in my life. Thank you so much, and I love you all. And to my special someone, my love, thank you for always being there for me and patiently waiting. Finally, we are now both graduates. Thank you for your continuous support and love. I am very grateful to have you at my side, and I love you very much. Finally, I want to thank everyone that I wasn't able to mention. Your presence, support, and encouragement have had a big contribution to my achievement, whether it was a helpful hand, advice, or an inspiration. Thank you. As we stand here today, embarking on a new chapter in our lives, let us reflect on the countless failures we have made, the sacrifices we did, and the hard work that has brought us to this very memorable moment. Being an irregular student indeed presents lots of struggles. Every enrollment is very stressful, as there are times that we thought that we might be able to enroll all the subjects, but then later find out that some subjects do still have prerequisite subjects that we were not able to take last semester. Sometimes, the subjects that we need to take are only available in certain semesters, which can delay our graduations. There are times that we feel like we are being left behind as we see our friends moving forward while we are still stuck studying. The struggles of seeing our parents working so hard for our education that's taking too long. Some people doubted us and said some hurtful words. Seeing ourselves less motivated in pursuing to finish the studies as there's this financial pressure that we feel, so instead of continuing studying, some choose to stop for work. These struggles show the determination and resilience of each of us, despite navigating a challenging and unique path. That is something that we should be proud of. We should focus on our progress and not comparing ourselves to others. The path that we take to success is not always linear. It has a lot of ups and downs, but every step that we take, no matter how small, is bringing us closer to our dreams. I want to remind every one of you that your dreams are very powerful. They are not just for your happiness, but also for your family. So as we move forward, let us continue to expand our horizons, embrace inclusivity, resilience, and innovation, and let our aspirations become our guide toward a future filled with endless possibilities. Congratulations to all of us. Mabuhay. May we continue to strive for the best and have a better future. Thank you.
Congratulations, we've just heard the word of thanks of our cum laude, Joaquin Andre G. Laroya. I'm sure the whole School of Arts and Sciences is very proud of you. Graduates, please stand as we do the pledge of loyalty to our alma mater, led by the president of the graduating class. Let us reaffirm our commitment to uphold the values of our institution. I'd like to call Mr. Vincent O. Endonella from the BSEE course.
Panumpa ng katapatan sa koleyo, itaas ang kanang kamay at sumunod sa akin. Matapos akong nanunumpa, bilang isang nakapagtapos sa Aurora Stage College of Technology, na buong husay kong lilinangin ang karunungan na kamit sa aming kolehiyo, na ang patnubay ay kalinangan sa makapilipinong gawain. Isa sa buhay ang mga bagay na makapagpapataas sa antas ng aking dignidad bilang isang tao. May malayang kaisipan, ipagbubunyi ang katotohanan, at maging ganap ang pagkilala sa katarungan ng batas, kung saan ang aking buhay taos-pusong iaalay sa Diyos, sa bayan at sangkatauhan. Kaya tulungan nawa ako ng Diyos.
Please remain standing as we proceed with the induction of our graduates into the ASCOT Alumni Association, led by Honorable Casper J.T. Ortiz, our association president.
Panunumpa sa pagsapi sa ASCOT Alumni Association, taas ang kanang kamay. Ako si, banggitin ang iyong pangalan, nagtapos sa Aurora State College of Technology, ay buong pusong nanunumpa na matapat ko ang tutuparin ang aking mga tungkulin at pananagutan. Bilang kasapi ng asosasyon ng mga natapos sa ASCOT, upang pangalagaan at ipagtanggol ang Constitution Isulong at ipagmalaki ang pangalan at mga mithiin na para lang pinagtapusan. Upang maging makatarungan sa bawat tao. At ang nangangakong maglilingkod sa ating bansa. Kaya tulungan nawa ako ng Diyos. Okay, congratulations.
As we near the conclusion of our ceremony, may we invite the graduates to join in singing the graduation song. It's your heartfelt tribute to your time here at ASCOT. And after the graduation song, we will conclude with the ASCOT hymn, accompanied by an audiovisual presentation, celebrating the rich history and tradition of our alma mater.
Aurora State College of Technology, sa lalawigan ng Aurora, pag-asa ka ng kabataan, kaganapan ng bayan, ang tapat mong bitaya, sa puso ko'y nakaugat na, ikaw naway patnubayan, na
finally, as the ASCOT NSTP ROTC exits with the callers, we invite you to remain standing for the reception, marking the end of our 37th commencement exercises. Once again, congratulations to the graduates of first semester, academic year 2023-2024. May you continue to soar to new heights, expand horizons, and make a positive impact on the world. Thank you and have a wonderful day. Thank you also for joining us in celebrating this momentous occasion to all of our parents and graduates. Mabuhay po kayo, wishing everyone a bright and prosperous future ahead. Goodbye and take care. We would like to invite all our academic deans. Let's have a group photo with our very generous and kind, our Honorable ROMMEL T. ANGARA. Graduates, we would like to have a groovy with you, if that's okay. Please remain where you are right now. Kasama po sa ating congressman and our guest speaker, mag-groovy po tayo. So mula dito sa stage, samama po kayo, okay? Alright, pwede po ba tayong talikuran natin sila for a groovy? Dito na lang po kayo sa stage. Ay, hindi po kaya. Sige po, sa baba po ang ating mga academic deans, key college officials, and Congressman ROMMEL ANGARA. Please stay po ang ating mga graduates. Let's have a groovy. Marami pong salamat sa inyong lahat. Also, sa lahat ng ating grad committee, sa ICTU, for our live stream, maaari niyo po itong balikan through our Facebook page, Aurora State College of Technology. Okay. Groovy po tayo. Ayan. Thank you so much. And to the team of Congressman ROMMEL. Thank you so much. Gather po tayo sa center. Please, graduates, join us. sa ating group picture? Sa gitna po tayo lahat. Everybody. Ayan, punta pa po sa gitna. Pwede po ba naming invite pang ilan sa mga graduates natin? Punta pa po tayo, samahan natin si Congressman. And thumbs up po tayong lahat. Thumbs up! Alright, mabuhay! Congratulations!